Okay, so I'm starting to feel a little bit like Bill Murray did in Groundhog Day. I'm once again sat in this chair, holding a massive shiny smartphone with a screen notch, dual lens camera and a glass back. I could pretty much cut and paste any other intro from any other phone review that I've done so far in 2018. And would anyone even notice? This here is the Zenfone 5, a sizable 6-inch plus smartphone packing a dual lens snapper, and oh look, there's a bit of screen notch action up top as well. Wonder where we've seen that before. Here's our full in-depth Zenfone 5 review. Oh, and don't forget to give us a subscribe and ding that notifications bell for lots of more exciting reviews of mobile tech. Cheers. Design-wise, this is very much like every other glass-coated, notch-rocking, hand-filling smartphone that I've reviewed so far this year. As you'd probably expect, this is one slippery, smooth beast. You definitely shouldn't rest it on the arm of a sofa at any point ever. That said, I've done that very exact same thing over and over and over again. And touch wood, beyond the tiniest little dent in the world in one of the corners, there is bugger all sign of any damage. And even though it's basically just a clone of several other 2018 smartphones, I do like the look of the Zenfone 5. There's almost no wasted space around the front, with a curvy aluminium frame breaking up the otherwise glossy surfacing. Of course, Huawei's funky gradient design on the P20 handsets and that disco-rific finish on the Honor 10 are still my favourites from this year. But that said, at least the Zenfone does boast that standard Asus swirly pattern as the light catches the back, which is still a pretty neat effect. These days, it's quite the novelty to find a smartphone packing a sub 6-inch screen, and the Zenfone certainly follows the trends in that area too. This flippin' enormous 6.2-inch IPS panel is basically designed for gaming and media on the move. And I can't deny that images look perfectly detailed thanks to that Full HD Plus resolution, while clarity is also superb even in really harsh light. And that display is also fully customizable too. If you dive into the charmingly titled Splendid settings, you can tweak the color output, fiddle with the likes of the color temperature and the saturation, and you can even make everything black and white if you want to pretend you live in the 1930s or something. Like pretty much all recent handsets, the Zenfone's display uses a stretched aspect ratio that's definitely better suited to enjoying movies on the move, not to mention making the phone more comfortable to clutch as well. And yes, brace yourself, that is indeed a notch sat right there at the top of the screen. Either side, you'll find the usual essential information stashed away, including the battery life and your reception level, but if the very thought of a damn dirty notch makes you physically sick for whatever reason, then no worries. You can just hide it away with a quick tap in the settings menu. Dive into the audio wizard section of the sound settings and you can configure the output to match your listening tastes. You can even create a listening profile which is optimized for your own particular headphones and your lugs. And the best part is the rather brilliant song for testing the results.
Say Asus starts with creation. Come along with passion. It is just the pursuit of perfection. If you know nothing about who we are, then come with me. Everybody say yes. U.S. Asus for all of us.
If you don't have a massive data allowance, you'll want to download a lot of musical videos to carry around with you. So the good news is that this bad boy comes with 64 gigs of storage as standard, and that can be expanded in a jiffy up to a rather generous 512 gigs via micro SD. Android Oreo has been lovingly smothered with Asus's own Zen UI 5 interface, which as usual adds a whole bunch of bonus bits. One of the biggest helps is definitely the one-handed mode. This allows you to minimize the screen at any point when you're struggling along with a bunch of shopping or something like that, and you don't have two hands free to operate the phone. And you can also use the fingerprint sensor to drag down the notifications bar as well, which is also a big help. And security has also been boosted in a couple of major ways. As well as that fingerprint sensor, you have a bit of facial recognition. It's not quite as strong as some of the others we've seen from the likes of OnePlus, but it's still pretty decent as long as the lighting conditions aren't too bad. Hidden away in there, you'll also find the likes of Game Genie, which allows you to record your gaming sessions and even stream direct to YouTube or Twitch. As the owner of a 3-year-old who's far too clever when it comes to tech, I'm also a big advocate of that kids mode, which basically gives you a lot of parental controls whenever they're handling your handset. And if you love gesture support, oh Christ, does the Zenfone have gesture support? Gesture support coming out of every orifice here. Inside of the Zenfone 5, you'll find a Qualcomm Snapdragon 636 chipset backed by 4GB of RAM. For everyday abilities, it's absolutely fine if not remarkable. You'll see some stutters and pauses and they'll catch you off guard every now and then, but still, apps generally run quite fine. Asus has even shoved in its own OptiFlex technology, which grants extra resources to your favourite apps and ensures that they don't stumble. The latest games won't trouble this phone either. You'll need to toggle down the detail levels in PUBG, but it still runs with a perfectly playable frame rate. and while the phone definitely heats up under pressure, it never feels like it's about to spontaneously combust. I did see some funny little glitches every now and then, however, such as apps locking up, or for instance, when you turn on the phone, it shows the time and date of when it was last unlocked rather than the actual time and date. Now, little glitches like that, they don't exactly ruin the overall experience, but they're not great. And in one memorable instance, the phone absolutely refused to shoot full HD 60 frames per second video, no matter how much I begged and pleaded. Thankfully, Asus has already zapped that last particular bug in an update which rolled out just a couple of days ago, so here's hoping that more of these little glitches can be kicked in the knackers pretty sharpish. Battery life is decent enough considering the size of this phone, matching the likes of the OnePlus 6. The 3300mAh cell will comfortably get you through the day if you're constantly piddling about with apps even. And thankfully, there is the usual array of power saving modes etc. when needed too. Now onto the really juicy stuff, that dual lens camera. This snapper uses a 12-megapixel f1.8 primary lens with a bit of optical image stabilization built in, which is quite rare at this kind of price point. This helps to keep things sharp by countering any hand motion when you're taking photos, especially in low light. And that primary lens is backed by an 8-megapixel f2.0 secondary lens, and this actually has a wide-angle view, which you can swap to at any point to get a very different result. To see what we think of the Zenfone 5's camera, just go check out our in-depth camera review, which is available right now. So in conclusion, the Zenfone 5 basically looks like every other phone, it smells like every other phone, and it definitely tastes like every other phone released in 2018 so far, but it does offer a lot of bang for your buck. It costs just 350 quid here in the UK, yeah, you get some pretty sleek design even if it is rather generic, some really strong media chops and some pretty decent camera tech as well. Not bad at all for that asking price. So that's our in-depth Asus Zenfone 5 review. Let us know what you think down in the comments below. The phone will be launching in the UK very shortly after this review goes live, so definitely go check it out if you're looking for a phone that's pretty dependable and around that sort of price point. Don't forget to give us a subscribe and ding that notifications bell as well for more on the latest and greatest tech. Cheers for watching, everyone. Love you. Bye.